Empyema and pleural effusion are two medical conditions that affect the pleural space, the thin, fluid-filled area between the lung's outer surface and the inner chest wall. Both of these conditions involve the accumulation of fluid, but they differ in the type of fluid, underlying causes, and management approaches. Understanding the difference is essential for the proper diagnosis and management of these conditions, which is what we will discuss in this quick video. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. A pleural effusion refers to the abnormal accumulation of fluid in the pleural space. It can occur for various reasons, including heart failure, pneumonia, cancer, liver or kidney disease, and other inflammatory or infectious conditions. Pleural effusions can be classified as either transudative or exudative, based on the nature of the fluid and the underlying cause. Transudative effusions occur when there is an imbalance in the production and absorption of pleural fluid, often due to increased hydrostatic pressure or decreased oncotic pressure. Common causes of transudative effusions include CHF, liver cirrhosis, and nephrotic syndrome. The fluid in transudative effusions is typically clear and contains low concentrations of proteins, cells, and other solutes. Exudative effusions, on the other hand, result from inflammation, infection, or injury to the pleura, leading to increased capillary permeability and leakage of protein cells and other solutes into the pleural space. Exudative effusions are often caused by conditions such as pneumonia, lung cancer, tuberculosis, autoimmune disorders, and pulmonary embolism. The fluid in exudative effusions is typically cloudy or bloody with higher concentrations of protein cells and other solutes compared to transudative effusions. Now let's talk about an empyema. An empyema is a specific type of pleural effusion that involves the accumulation of pus in the pleural space due to a bacterial, fungal, or less commonly, a parasitic infection. It is often a complication of pneumonia, chest surgery, or a lung abscess. Empyema is characterized by the presence of a large number of white blood cells, dead cells, and microorganisms, leading to a thick, purulent fluid. This fluid may become loculated, forming septations or pockets that can further complicate treatment. The diagnosis of a pleural effusion and empyema typically involves a combination of medical history, physical examination, imaging studies such as chest x-rays and CT scans, and the analysis of pleural fluid obtained through thoracentesis. The distinction between the two conditions is important as the management and treatment differ significantly. Treatment for pleural effusion depends on the underlying cause and severity. Transudative effusions often resolve with treatment of the primary condition, such as using diuretics for congestive heart failure. In contrast, exudative pleural effusions may require more invasive interventions, such as thoracentesis or chest tube placement to drain the fluid and relieve symptoms. Empyema requires more aggressive treatment due to the presence of an infection. Initial management includes antibiotics targeting the causative organism, drainage of the infected fluid through chest tube placement, and supportive care. In more advanced or complicated cases, surgical interventions such as video-assisted thoracoscopic surgery or open thoracotomy with decortication may be necessary to remove the infected material and fibrous tissue, allowing the lungs to re-expand. So in summary, both empyema and pleural effusion involve the accumulation of fluid in the pleural space, but they have distinct causes, characteristics, and implications for treatment. Pleural effusion can be a result of various medical conditions, leading to either transudative or exudative fluid accumulation. In contrast, empyema is a specific type of pleural effusion caused by an infection, resulting in the buildup of pus within the pleural space. Proper diagnosis and distinction between these conditions are essential to ensure appropriate and effective management. If you want to support the channel, please like and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it. And there should be some other helpful videos popping up on your screen right about now that I think you'll enjoy. And just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for informational purposes only. Thank you so much for watching. Have a blessed day. And as always, breathe easy, my friend.